Hello everyone, my name is Dr. Saurabh Mani Tripathi and you are watching my YouTube channel Davali Lectures. The topic of this short lecture is continuous time versus discrete time signals and analog versus digital signals. In my preceding short video lecture, I had described various terms, namely signal, system, system behavior, system analysis, and mathematical model of the system. In this short video lecture, I will first describe the continuous time and discrete time signals and thereafter the analog and digital signals. I will also highlight why the terms analog and digital should not be confused with the terms continuous time and discrete time. So let us now understand the continuous and discrete time classifications of the signals. Actually, a signal which is defined at every instant along the time axis is known as a continuous time signal. For example, look at this illustration. You may see at every instant along the time axis, the signal does assume some value. So, this is a continuous time signal. On the other hand, look at this illustration. In this illustration, you may notice that the signal is assuming values only at equally spaced discrete instants along the time axis. This is nothing but a discrete time signal, since this signal is defined only at discrete instants of time. So one may now state a signal which is defined only at discrete instants along the time axis is known as the discrete time signal. Now look at this figure. This figure illustrates a relationship between a continuous time signal and a discrete time signal. Actually, by sampling the continuous time signal at a uniform rate, one may derive the discrete version of the signal. Here, the symbol T has been used to denote time in case of the continuous time signal. On the other hand, the symbol K has been used to denote time instants in case of the discrete time signal. Now the question is, what are the analog and digital classifications of the signals? Very often, the terms analog and digital are confused with that of continuous time and discrete time. If you presume likewise, then you are also making a big mistake. As I have already described, the terms continuous time and discrete time qualify the nature of a signal along the time axis, or you may say along the horizontal axis. On the other hand, the terms analog and digital qualify the nature of the signal along the amplitude axis, or you may say along the vertical axis. Keeping this key difference in view, we may describe the analog and digital classifications of the signals. Now look at this illustration. You may observe that the signal is taking on an infinite number of values along the amplitude, or you may say along the vertical axis. Actually, a signal whose amplitude can take on any value in a continuous range along the vertical axis is known as an analog signal. So this figure illustrates nothing but an analog signal. Now, look at this illustration. You may observe that the signal amplitude is taking on only a finite number of values along the vertical axis. Actually, a signal whose amplitude can take on only a finite number of values along the vertical axis is known as a digital signal. So, this figure illustrates a digital signal. Another example of digital signal is the signal interacting in a digital computer, whose amplitude takes on only two binary values, that is 0 and 1. However, it is worth mentioning here, in order to qualify a signal as digital one, the number of values which the signal amplitude takes on need not be restricted to 2. It can be any number, but finite. Now see, the illustration of the analog signal once more. It is worth noting that the analog signal illustrated in this figure qualifies to be a continuous time signal also, since at every instant along the time axis, the signal does assume some value. Since this signal is defined at every instant along the time axis and the amplitude of the signal is taking on an infinite number of values along the vertical axis. So, we must call this signal a continuous time analog signal. Similarly, the digital signal illustrated in this figure also qualifies to be a continuous time signal. Since this signal is defined at every instant along the time axis and the amplitude of the signal is taking on only a finite number of values along the vertical axis, so we must call this signal a continuous time digital signal. As I have already stated, one may derive the discrete version of a continuous time signal just by sampling the signal at a uniform rate. Therefore, the discrete versions of these two continuous time signals can be represented as shown now on your screen. Notice that this signal is defined only at discrete instants along the time axis. Also, the amplitude of the signal is taking on an infinite number of values along the vertical axis. So, we must call this particular signal a discrete time analog signal. Furthermore, when we look at this particular signal, it is defined only at discrete instants along the time axis. However, the amplitude of the signal is taking on only a finite number of values along the vertical axis. So, we must call this signal a discrete time digital signal. While summarizing in one sentence what I have discussed in this short video lecture, I may state analog signal not necessarily be continuous time and digital signal need not be discrete time. I hope you are now able to explain others why the terms analog and digital should not be confused with the terms continuous time and discrete time. That's it for now. Thanks for watching. Goodbye.